Life as an astronaut is dangerous to say the least, but what are the invisible threats posed by the deepest reaches of outer space? Our knowledge of space has advanced in countless ways thanks to the hands-on experience of astronauts. The majority of us can only dream of traveling out into the world beyond our own, of course, and those who make it are a very privileged few. As astronaut Reid Wiseman puts it,
"So when the engine cuts out and you get to look back at Earth, absolutely every sacrifice is worth it, every dream is worth it, the entire road there is worth it, every bit of it is worth it."
It's not the easiest life, though. In a 2011 NASA interview, astronaut Charles J. Kamada was more than frank about the struggles of becoming an astronaut. He said, "Let me tell you what it is not like to be an astronaut. It is not all glory, games, fun, and adventure. With the long, grueling training, the time-consuming studying, and the technical expertise required to even be considered, becoming an astronaut may be a very different experience from what some starry-eyed dreamers might expect. Then, of course, there's the reason for all the safety training. Space travel is, by its very nature, potentially dangerous." Kamada highlighted this tragic fact too, noting, "I was training in Russia when we got the call that Space Shuttle Columbia broke up over Texas during Earth entry and the crew was lost. I lost 7 friends." On top of this, space travel takes a toll on astronauts' bodies. In fact, a recent study has suggested that it may be capable of mutating their cells. The 2022 paper, Retrospective Analysis of Somatic Mutations and Clonal Hematopoiesis in Astronauts, offers a glimpse into this phenomenon. The researchers reportedly obtained blood samples from 14 astronauts who flew short missions in the space shuttle between 1998 and 2001. After 2 decades of storage and freezing temperatures, these blood samples have provided some fascinating insights. The blood samples used were taken 3 days after the astronauts returned from space. The astronauts reportedly had not been exposed to any form of radiation therapy before or after their mission, but their DNA appeared to have some traits similar to those found in irradiated humans. Specifically, the researchers found that a gene known as TP53 had been frequently mutated in this group of astronauts. However, TP53 mutations are uncommon in patients without a history of cancer therapy. In fact, every single astronaut involved in the study displayed some kind of mutation in their DNA. The mutations occurred in the hematopoietic stem cells, which play a critical role in producing mature blood cells. There is a good reason for this, too. Space is practically rife with radiation, and astronauts are typically exposed to a significant amount of it during their missions. This space radiation is a unique danger faced by spacefarers because the rest of us here on Earth are protected by the planet's atmosphere. Even astronauts on the International Space Station are afforded protection against the worst of it. Unfortunately, these mutations are connected with higher chances of contracting cancer of the blood, as well as a number of heart conditions. So maybe that's why NASA isn't taking this danger lightly. As the organization's own Ruthann Lewis stated in 2019, "Radiation is always present, whether you're in orbit, in transit, or on a planetary surface. From mitigation techniques to protection and enclosures, we're considering this in every environment astronauts will be in." NASA's own human research program studies the physical effects space travel has or might theoretically have on the human body. Monitoring the effects of such hazards as gravity fields will help to pave the way for potential trips to Mars and even beyond. After all, the pioneers who embark on these missions may well be pivotal to the survival of the human race, so it's vital that they are protected along the way.